Calculations enable you to create new data and answer questions that cannot be answered by the source columns. In a report, three types of calculations can be created: simple, query, and layout. Using a calculation in a report can make it more meaningful by deriving additional information from the data source. Calculations created in a report are available only in that report. Calculations can be added to lists, crosstabs, and other data containers such as data tables, and to a page, header, body, or footer. If a calculation is going to be used in multiple reports or by multiple authors, create it in a data module so it can be used by the wider audience. In this video, you will see how to create a calculation using two numeric columns on a report, how to create a query calculation, how dates can be used in a calculation, and how to create a layout calculation. The simple list report in the top left corner is a report that I created, and it's going to be my starting point in this video. The report in the bottom right corner is where the video will finish. In this video, I'm starting with a simple list report that I created. The report was built using the call center data module, which is in samples. I want to create a simple calculation that will derive the percentage portion of handle time, which is made up of talk time. In order to do that, I select the two columns and click the Insert Calculation icon. I can see a number of calculations are presented to me. I'm going to select percentage talk time handle time, and the calculation will be done for me. And this will also become my column header. If I'd wanted to give it a different name, I would have clicked custom. And at that point, I can provide my own name. Query calculations can be used to create calculations with more than two numeric values, data that's not on the report, and complex calculations that may require functions. Selecting the icon toolbox and expanding textual, query calculation is dragged out onto the report. In the expression editor, data can come from source, data items, which are report items, or from queries. Functions are also available to create the calculation. Operators include mathematical operations like addition. Constructs include logic functions like if, then, else. Notice when I select a function, the syntax and an example appears in the information pane. To create a calculation using data from different tables, the tables must be related with a join. I know that the agent and call log tables are joined, so I can use them to calculate my cost per call. Dropping hourly rate into the expression definition, I'm going to divide it by 3600 because I want to calculate a per second rate. And I'm going to multiply that by the handle time from the call log. I'm going to change the name. And the new column has been added to the report. One interesting thing to note here is the formatting has been picked up from the hourly cost, so I get the currency formatting done for me. Non-numeric data can also be used in a calculation. Dragging the employment start date onto the report. In this case, what I want to do is calculate the hire year. Selecting the employment start date and the insert calculation, I can see a number of calculated values are available to me. Now I could click year with the employment start date and that would become my column heading. But if I wanted to provide my own heading, I could click Custom. Make year my operation. At this point, I could just delete the employment start date if I don't need it on my report. I can use a calculation to group data. So for example, if I wanted to group hire year into aggregate buckets, clicking the insert calculation, and I'm going to define custom groups. I'm going to use the lowest value to 2010 and the group name and my newbies will be in this case anyone with a higher year of 2011 to the highest value. I'm going to click use custom name and I'll call it demographics. Layout calculations can be used to add runtime information to reports such as current date. Clicking the toolbox and expanding textual, I pick up the layout calculation, and in this case, I'm going to drop it up in the predefined heading area, selecting function and report functions. In this case, what I want to do is I want to show the report name. Now, because I have page preview turned on, I can see right away that the report name will appear in the report. This concludes the video on how to add calculations to a report. You've seen how to create a calculation using existing data on a report, how to use a query calculation, how to manipulate dates with calculations, and how to create and add a layout calculation. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.